Hey guys, this is David Kwan. Recently, I think 2 weeks ago, I made a video talking about social work and what you can achieve with a social work degree and what kind of careers are there with the social work degree. And I said there are so many fields of social work. And some fields of social work are actually really good paying career paths. You could take the clinical path of becoming a psychologist, a psychiatrist, a clinical therapist, and you could make a really good deal of money. You could become a head, or a founder, or a CEO of a nonprofit organization. And you know, that it's not as you definitely will not get nearly as paid as well as a CEO of a for-profit business. But you would certainly be earning a pretty good amount of income to be able to do what you do. But social work is also full of fields that's not the case. It's a pretty tough field. If you don't have a passion for what you're doing, you might as well do something else. Social work is not a field if you want to make a good living for your... Well, you can still make a good living for yourself no matter what social work job you do. I'm not saying that social work jobs are shit jobs. I'm just saying that you need a drive for a lot of social work jobs. You need to really believe in what you're doing. And there are two social work fields, in my opinion, that are really the toughest. They have the highest burnout rates. And burnout rate is, you know, when you retire or when you quit that particular career because it's too much for you. You just move on to something else because you can no longer do it. You're no longer capable of doing it. And social work field in general, compared to other disciplines, has an extremely high burnout field. For you know, it makes sense. It's not an easy field. You have to see a lot of shit. You have to deal with a lot of shit, all with a smile on your face, and a compassionate behavior. So it's hard. But there are two fields that I know that even myself, I would not be able to enter this field and survive really well, at least for me. You know, there are a lot of people who can excel in this field, and I say really props to them. But the first social work kind of path I want to talk about is end-of-life care or terminal care. And that's really what it's called. I know that sounds really morbid, but... I think maybe they have some other terms for this kind of career path, but it's pretty much what it's called, end-of-life care, and it's not really self-explanatory, but this is kind of what my really closest friend's mom's ex-boyfriend did this. Keyword being did. He no longer, he burnt out. But it's when... You know, you're like a companion to people who have terminal illnesses. They know they're about to die, and they are about to die, and they will die in 10 months' time, in a year's time, in a 2 years' time. They have a terminal illness. Their life has been pretty much, or their death has been pretty much scheduled, and they know they're about to die. So what social workers do in end-of-life care is to become their companion, is to really... help them live their lives and deal with this knowledge that they're going to die pretty soon. And why this is such a path with such a high burnout rate is because, well, if you end up becoming a companion and really, really, really interact with people, you become attached to them. They become like, you know, social workers are supposed to keep this boundary as a worker, you know, but it's hard. It's hard not to become like friends to clients. So what ends up happening is you become attached, but you have all these clients who are all terminally ill, and they will all die pretty soon. You develop an emotional connection with them, that person dies. You have to kind of grieve through that, but then there's another person who you become so attached to, that person dies. So what makes this field so hard is it takes an emotional toll on you. You become to love these amazing clients that you interact with and that you help, but you live longer than them. So it's a lot of these social workers who burn out end up having post-traumatic stress disorder, a you know, what's the other thing that I wanted to, you know, they have the disorder, they have, a lot of, they also, survivor's guilt, they end up having survivor's guilt, a lot of just anxiety disorders, they need therapy. You know, the most important thing to me with everyone should have therapy, regular therapy, and especially social workers. It doesn't matter if you don't have a mental illness or whatever. I think it's really healthy to seek that kind of help from a professional. And even professionals, especially professionals, need that kind of help. So that's one field where I probably know, like, I feel like I will really enjoy doing. But I know with my personality, I will be burnt out really quickly. And I believe the burnt out rate in that field is around the age of 44 or 43 or so, which is extremely early. So we're saying that people in their early, like mid-40s or early 40s, are just quitting their career because it's too overwhelming. For example, my closest friend's mom's ex-boyfriend was in end-of-life care, but he ended up becoming a taxi cab driver because he burnt out. That's an example there. The other field is foster care or management of foster care. It's a field that is demonized by the public, and it's the mainstream public, I think, know social workers the most with the image of a child protective services agent, you know. And the people burn out in this field because of the bureaucracy involved in foster care, because of the policies involved in it, because they are demonized. You know, when you're doing what you think are good things, but everyone hates you for doing it, it's going to take a toll on you. If everyone thinks you're this evil person for taking a child out of a home that you thought was, you thought you had the evidence that it was an abusive home, but it turns out you just took a child and put that child into a worse family situation, you had noble intentions, but the end result has become terrible. People are not going to look at your noble intentions. People are only going to look at the results, and they're going to blame you for it. So, yeah. Very tough field, and this is, I think this is the number one in burnout. I think the burnout is about 41 and 42. Pretty ridiculous. But I just wanted to talk about these two types of social work to kind of bring up the point that it's very, like, depending on what kind of social workers a person is, or I feel like it's one of those fields where you start out so passionate and so driven, but because of the toll it can take on the worker itself, the worker is not a robot. The worker is a human being. You know, if social workers were sort of this robot who can kind of compartmentalize their emotions as, you know, it's like, oh, I'm at work, so I'm not going to have any emotions. I'm just going to do my work the best way I can. And then when I'm home, then I'm going to be free to have jokes and share sad stories with my friends. If human beings were capable of doing this like robots, social workers would be really awesome at their jobs. But unfortunately, social workers are humans too. And that's really the point I wanted to bring home, and to bring awareness to the fact that, you know, you might not like the end results of a social work. I can't see how you would end up not liking the end result of end-of-life care, because these are the people who work to make sure that they die as happily and peaceful as possible. But, you know, it's not, when you focus so much on the end results, it can be pretty harmful. Intentions matter, the way we do things matter, and meanings matter. I'm now digressing to a whole different line of thought, but it really, that's really just what I wanted to talk about in this video. And I just really find it interesting, the so many paths in social work, and I'm still not really sure what path I would take. I'm going to be starting graduate school for social work this fall, so yeah, I know my passions in this field, you know. I'm usually involved in fighting improving or ending homelessness, poverty, and things related to HIV and AIDS and such. I know my focus, but it's just, you know, seeing the whole social work career path as a whole, it's an interesting picture. I definitely know I'm probably not going to end up in a clinical field or management field. And I would love to do end-of-life care, but knowing my personality, I don't think I can handle that. And the, you know, foster care is something I always had a good drive for in the beginning, but then I started learning about how it works, and I think I would have so many problems with how the system actually is that I probably would be burnt out. So that's my video. Feel free to share any comments or whatever you think. So yeah, cheers.